Let's talk about reading scholarly articles. In this video, you'll learn how to identify and read scholarly articles. We know they can be long and full of jargon, which can be intimidating, but hopefully some of the strategies you'll learn in this video will help you navigate the world of academic research. Today we'll cover peer review, identifying scholarly articles, navigating the common sections found in scholarly articles, and some tips on reading and note-taking. So let's start with peer review. Most, but not all, scholarly articles go through a process called peer review, in which the author's peers, or other qualified professionals in their field, evaluate the article before publication. Although we're talking about scholarly articles, I also want to note that most books and edited volumes published by university presses are also peer-reviewed. You can usually find out if an article is peer-reviewed by looking at the entry in the database where you found the article. Here's an example of what that might look like in Academic Search Ultimate. You can also check out the database Ulrich's Web, which will tell you whether an article is peer-reviewed or not. But remember, not all scholarly articles are peer-reviewed. So how else can you figure out if something is or isn't a scholarly article? Something as simple as an article's title can often give you a hint. Scholarly articles typically have very specific and descriptive titles, and sometimes use discipline-specific jargon. For example, Post-Western Poetics, Postmodern Appropriation Art in Australia. On the other hand, a popular article title would be something more catchy, like, Should We Retire the Concept of Appropriation in Art? This is the type of title you'll probably find in a newspaper, magazine, or a website. You can also often recognize a scholarly article by looking up the author and their credentials. The author of a scholarly article will typically have an advanced academic degree, and they're often affiliated with an academic institution or research center. Popular article authors, on the other hand, may have a degree in journalism or a related field, and they're most likely associated with a newspaper or magazine. Another thing to look for is a list of references, sometimes referred to as bibliography or references, at the end of the article. Scholarly articles will typically have a long list of references, whereas popular articles will usually not have a reference list at all. If the author does cite sources, they will often be hyperlinked directly within the text. Here's just the first page of the long list of references at the end of the article, Post-Western Poetics, Postmodern Appropriation Art in Australia, for example. Now that you can identify a scholarly article, let's get some tips on how to read them. There are lots of different types of scholarly articles, and they may read differently depending on the field. Articles in the sciences and social sciences, like biology, psychology, and anthropology, for example, typically follow a fairly consistent structure. They often have different sections like an abstract, introduction, literature review, methods, results, conclusion, and references. Not all articles in these fields will have these sections, but they are a good example of what you might see. So let's dig into them. An abstract is a concise summary of the article, including its purpose, main argument, as well as the implications of that argument. Sometimes the abstract will appear at the top of the article, and sometimes you'll find it in the database you're searching. Abstracts can be really helpful for your research. Look at this one from a Journal of Social Psychology. It not only talks about the main purpose of the article, but also addresses their methodology and the implications of the research. Let's look a little more closely. Here you can see the findings of the study, and here you can see the methodology used. At the beginning, the main purpose of the article is discussed, and finally, at the end of the abstract, the implications of the research are discussed. The abstract is going to be the most important thing you read from a scholarly journal article because it will let you know how to read the rest of the article. But keep in mind, it's not good practice to quote from an abstract. Remember, the abstract is just a summary of the article, so if you want to pull quotes and cite things, you will need to dig deeper into the content of the article. After the abstract, you'll usually find an introduction and literature review. The introduction typically introduces the reader to the topic or research question the authors explored. The literature review functions a bit differently. It is usually used to describe the previous research that has been published on the topic. The literature review is a great place to go if you need background information or want to know what other scholars have written in comparison to the article you're currently reading. Next up, you'll usually find a methods section. This section will outline any procedures used to carry out the research study. This could include case studies, survey, field data collection, and more. Keep in mind that the methods used can vary widely by discipline. After the methods section, you will usually find the results of the study. In the results, you'll find all the data that was collected during the research process. These often take the form of charts, tables, and graphs. Finally, the discussion and conclusion section of a scholarly article is very important. A scholarly article published in the sciences or social sciences will usually end with a conclusion where the findings are summarized. The authors may also discuss how their findings relate to other research or encourage other scholars to follow up on their work. Now let's talk about scholarly articles in the humanities. Humanities disciplines include fields like art history, philosophy, classics, languages, and history. Scholarly articles in the humanities may have more variety and structure than social science and science articles typically have. They usually don't follow the same formal section structure, instead weaving evidence throughout. Furthermore, they often don't use statistical analyses or methodologies, but rely on primary sources or textual analysis to support their arguments. They will usually still have an abstract, conclusion, and references, so you can use these tools to determine the relevance of an article in a humanities field for your own research. Now let's talk about some reading strategies specific to scholarly articles. First off, you don't need to read the entire article in order. Anyone who does a lot of scholarly reading will tell you this. It can be really overwhelming to read an article from start to finish when you first encounter it. Instead, first read that abstract. If the abstract fits within the scope of your research, read more. If it doesn't, don't bother reading the article. Then jump down to the discussion and conclusion. This is the essential part of the article. It will tell you what the authors learned. Then, circle back up to the introduction and literature review. This will give you helpful background and context. Finally, if the article fits within the scope of your research, read the whole thing. And don't forget about that references section. It can be really helpful in building your own bibliography. Here are just a few more reading tips to help you in your research process. First, make sure to take notes as you go. That way, if you find a fact or quote, you can note the page number to save you time later. Also, make sure you're reading critically. Ask yourself questions like, what do you already know about this topic? Do you agree with the author? Does what the author says match the other information you found on this topic? And as always, don't hesitate to reach out to us at asklib@jhu.edu. We're here to help.